Ashe Goddesses, thank you so much for tuning in right here with the monthly Sacred Circle. I want to show you how to get started and how to set up your altar, because you have to have an altar to get started. I finally set aside a space for me with my altar, and I'm going to show you some things that you're going to need so that you can set up your altar wherever your sacred place may be within your home. Please understand that that space has to be a clean area. It has to be a sacred area where you can go and find solitude, find peace, as well as clear your mind. So I'm going to show you some things that I use while on this journey of awakening. This is a must-have that I want to share with all goddesses. Get you some liquid chlorophyll and a bottle of alkaline or spring water. The best spring water to me is Ozark. I don't have any Ozark, but if you can get some water and put lemon in it, that will be even better. Just water with lemon, so you can make your own alkaline water. And then you take one dropper of the liquid chlorophyll. And liquid chlorophyll is green. And it's something that you find in the plants. It's what makes the plants green. So once you put it in your water, you're going to notice that it's going to be green. Okay? And so you can drink this throughout the entire day. What this does is help neutralize your pH, bring your pH balance within you down to a point where it's supposed to be. A normal pH for our bodies is 7.5. So you want to maintain a 7.5 pH level, because at 7.5, no disease can live in an alkalized body, and that's what you want to do. And when your body is alkalized, you can hear very clear as well. So it doesn't have a taste to it. It has like a little minty green taste. There's no side effects, so it doesn't matter if you're on any type of medication or whatever, you still can take this. It's completely safe. No side effects. Only thing you'll get is green poop. But nevertheless, other than that, it's very safe to take. Also, I have a crystal. This crystal, someone gave me a crystal when I went to, I'm going to speak in Wisconsin, and they blessed me with a crystal. So I wanted to share with you my crystal that I have on my altar. And this crystal, you want to make sure that you get a crystal that resonates with you, because crystals are alive. Crystals, they are alive. They can bring healing to you, or they can not bring healing. So you want to make sure that your crystal resonates with you. You can tell if it resonates with you, because you'll start feeling peaceful. You'll start feeling certain ways when you touch it or when it's around you. Different things will start manifesting. And for those of you who may read scripture or understand the Bible, said never let a rock cry out in my space. This lets us know that even a rock, a crystal, is alive. And it does have healing properties to it. So you're going to need a crystal. Find a crystal that resonates with you. Then also, I have sage, and I noticed that a lot of people talk bad about sage and say, you know, that's demonic. What is bad about sage? What sage does, once you light it, you take your sage, once you light it, it smokes, and what it does, it clears. You want to clear your altar area with the sage. You want to take it and just clear the area. And what sage does, it purifies the area. It purifies you. Then you want to take some and purify you. Any different negative energies that have attached itself to you, you want to clear it off of you. Okay? So you want to get you some sage. Sometimes during our monthly circles, you may see me light my sage and clear the area prior to teaching or prior to sharing. Also, I have a humidifier. After I burn my sage. I take some sweet smelling aromatherapy oil, such as in here now I have frankincense and myrrh, but you could take something very sweet smelling and put in your water and humidifier and the oil, you mix it together in your humidifier and you burn it. So after you remove out and clear out all negative energies with your sage, then you want to welcome fresh energy in, sweet smelling energy in, or energy back in, positive energy. You want to welcome that back within your space. So also I have a candle. Okay, it's in the form of a Himalayan rock, and it's a candle that I may light, you know, before I even get started. And what that does is reminding me that I am to be the light. So lighting a candle reminds you of being the light. It reminds you of, it should remind you of your purpose. Your purpose here within this earth realm is for you to be the light and be the city. Be the city that shineth for all mankind to see. As you are awakening, you can't do different things that you used to do. Fear does not reside in your city. Fear does not reside in your temple. Your temple is you. Your city is you. Your earth is you. So please realize that you have to do different things to manifest as the expression of God. You and I, as goddesses, we are to be the womb of the world. We are to cultivate, nourish the world. We're supposed to send out vibrations of love, rhythm of joy, rhythm of peace. But if the womb is sick, and if the womb has so much pain, we won't be able to do those things that we are designed to do. So this is the reason why I wanted to do a sacred circle, and this is the reason why you have to prepare to do a sacred circle. You have to prepare to manifest so that you can be a bright light within your region. You can be that vibrant light within your region. So it's going to take some work. You have to go through healing, and the sacred circles are going to help you to heal from a lot of pain, a lot of issues. We're going to have to go in the underworld, and the underworld is that lower place where all of your childhood secrets, all of your childhood pain has been embedded. Then another thing you may want to get, or you may want to channel into YouTube and listen for shamanic drumming. Listen to shamanic drumming, and as you're listening to the shamanic drumming, meditate. Clear your mind. And how I meditate is simply, I focus in on breath. I breathe in and I breathe out. And sometimes when I breathe in, I hold it for 5 seconds, then I release. Breathe in, hold, release. And as you're doing this, you're clearing your mind. This keeps your mind in a neutral zone. Every time when different thoughts that you feel like you're projecting, you're initializing those thoughts, then begin to meditate to clear so that you'll be able to hear. And you'll know when your inner or the ancestors begin to manifest and begin to share different things in your mind. Because you'll know that, hey, that's out of your realm of thinking. So that's what you want to do. You want to be able to take your mindset to a whole new different level of thinking. And in order to take your mindset to a whole new level of thinking, you have to meditate. Every morning, a goddess is to awaken. She is to get up. She is to meditate. I don't care if it's 2 minutes. You have to start somewhere. Set your altar up. Once you set up your altar, clear your space. Make sure that you're in a quiet space. Maybe when everybody is asleep, or when everybody's gone to work and you're there by yourself, this is a time for you to clear your space. This is the time for you to affirm and begin to speak things out in the universe so that the universe can take hold of the sound waves that you're projecting out of your mouth and manifest it. Because now, as you're a fifth dimensional being, whatever you think is going to manifest into the third dimension. Because your whole objective of being a goddess and recognizing that you're a goddess is to be the new heaven and the new earth here in this realm. A lot of negativity you cannot be involved in anymore. A lot of religious circles you cannot be involved in anymore, because those things will pull you backwards. And there's a scripture that says, let the dead bury the dead. You were caught up in a twinkling of an eye to bring change, to bring vibration to the world, to bring healing to the world. But before we can get to that step, we have to deal with us. And for that cause, I welcome you here with me in our monthly Goddess Circle. So be on the lookout for your weekly emails. Be on the lookout for your guided meditations. You're going to receive some bonuses. You will have to go through a 4 weeks course. So you'll get a video once a week for 4 weeks, helping you along this journey. So after you finish with your 4 weeks in that month, then you're going to have to pay again the $39.99, so we can start the process all over. Each circle will be a new circle theme. It will be a newness where we're going to start and we're going to deal with issues. And then guess what? You get another 4 weeks course, and it's going to be a different course. So stay the course. Don't get weary in well doing. Beloved, you have been upgraded, and I'm so happy that you're connected with me for a time such as this. Shalom.